Okay, everyone.
Excuse me.
Okay, everyone, thank you very much for coming today. Today we have three distinguished speakers. Mr. Yasushi Aoto. Yasushi Aoto, the director of the Japan Association of Child Poverty and Education Support. Chieko Kuribayashi-san of the Waku Waku Children's Cafeteria, and Mr. George McGilton of Second Harvest Japan, Japan's first food bank, if I believe. Just jump right into it. Aoto-san will start explaining what his organization does and follow up by Kuribayashi-san and McGilton. And after that, the floor will be open to Q&A. So thank you very much. And
good afternoon, everybody.
私はですね、全国の今子どもの貧困に対してどう解決するか、教育学びですね、ラーニングを中心として、解決しようというふうに、頑張っている全国の団体の、リーダーです。
I am the leader of a national network of organizations who are working to use learning as the center for alleviation of the national child poverty issue.
今からですね、今子ども、日本の子どもたちが置かれている現状をまず概略的にお話をしたいと思います。
First of all, I would like to provide an overview of the situation faced by children in Japan today.
この図はですね、子どもの貧困率の推移と家族形態です。で、
This graph demonstrates the situation of the estimates in regards to poverty rates for children in Japan and family formations.
この25年間で日本の子どもたちが非常に、子どもたちの状況が非常に厳しくなっていることがよくお分かりだと思います。
And I believe that this demonstrates indeed how difficult the situation of children in Japan has become gradually over the past 25 years.
特に、日本ではですね、1990年にバブルが崩壊をした後の、このですね、貧困化、まあ、貧困化の問題というのは2つ要因があって、1つは雇用と教育に2つ大きな責任がありますけれども、それが非常に厳しくなっている。
And particularly in the case of Japan following the collapse of the bubble, there has been an increase in poverty. There are two factors, mostly the causes for these, and this is employment and education.
16.3% というのは子どもの数、17歳以下でいうと350万人です。
And if we look at the figure here, which is listed as 16.3%, this is representing children of the age 17 and under, and this actually represents a number of 3.5 million.
4人世帯でだいたい300万円以下世帯というふうに考えられています。300万円。
And so this demonstrates the families who are living on the amount of well under 3 million yen.
これは小中学生で公立の小中学生の就学援助というふうに言われていますけれども、この就学援助は学校に通うためにどうしても必要な、これがなければ学校に通えないという子どもたちがこれだけ多いという、これは一つのエビデンスです。
And this is representing those children in elementary and junior high schools, in public elementary and junior high schools, who are requiring school expense subsidies in order to attend school. So they would be unable to attend school without such subsidies.
これも子どもの貧困率と似通った数字ですけど、大体 16%。
And this number is actually very close to the number of children who are living in rates of poverty, which is also around 16%.
日本の子どもの全ての子どもの6人に1人です。
So this represents one in six of all children in Japan.
非常に深刻なのはこのデータで、これは、日本の高齢者と生産年齢人口の、比率です。
And the next graph demonstrates some very serious data here. This represents the number of the productive age of people, or the population, the productive population in Japan, which is required to support one elderly person.
2010年は3人の生産年齢人口が1人の高齢者を支える。
And so we can see, for example, in 2010, there were close to 3 people within the productive population who were supporting one elderly person.
今20歳代で大学行っている若者たち、20歳代の若者が60歳代の高齢者になる頃には、1人しか自分を支えてくれる、働いてくれる人はいません。
However, for the people who are now in their 20s and attending university, when they reach their 60s, there will only be one person from the productive population who will be able to support them in their old age.
日本の高齢化は世界の先進国の中で最も深刻なものです。
The aging society in Japan is indeed the most severe of all developed countries in the world now.
貧困の問題と貧困の問題と高齢化問題は全く重なり合ったものです。
And the issue of poverty and the aging population are very much two parts of the same issue.
それはすなわち少子化で日本のですね、労働力世代が労働力層が非常に減少していく日本社会の衰退を意味します。
And so as we are seeing also less children being born, there is also this reduced working age population as well.
このデータは日本の空き家の問題です。これは地方だけではなくて、首都圏でも空き家は極めて深刻です。今、
This data reflects the number of empty houses in Japan. This is not only an issue for rural areas, but also for here in the Tokyo metropolitan area as well.
今日本全国で空き家は 13% あります。
And the current national figures for empty homes in Japan has reached 13%.
15年後には3件に1件、3分の1が空き家になります。
And it is estimated that 15 years from now, 1 in 3 homes will be vacant.
少子化問題とこの少子化問題と空き家問題、空き家というのはまさに日本社会が力を失っていく、確実に衰退していくということを、まあ、将来的に見えると思います。
And so the issue of the lowering birth rates and the increase of vacant homes in Japan very much demonstrates the well decrease or the weakening of the Japanese power of the society.
結婚しない若者たちも非常に増えています。
There is also a great increase in young people who are choosing not to get married.
これは結婚できない、しないのではなくて、実際、賃金が安くてできないのです。
And this is not actually an issue of, sorry, choosing to get married, but actually those who are not able to get married due to low income and such other reasons.
日本の若者の自殺率は先進国の中でも一貫してトップです。
The Japanese suicide rate for youth also is consistently at the top of all developed countries.
日本の我々の試算では日本の教育費は世界でも最も高いと思います。
We also, well, according to our figures or our estimates, the cost for education fees in Japan is also one of the highest in the world.
日本の大学進学率は 54% ですけれども、大学に進学していった若者たちの今 10% は中退していきます。
The rate of young people going on to university in Japan is 54%, but actually the rate of those who drop out from there is 10%.
最大の要因は、授業料を払えないのです。
And the greatest reason for this is that they are unable to pay their school fees.
日本の私立大学の平均的な授業料は今100万円を超えます。1年間でです。
And the, for example, the annual school fees for a private university in Japan is now over 1 million yen per year.
4年間通うとほぼ600万円かかると言われます。
If you were to attend a university for 4 years, this would reach close to 6 million yen for the course.
家計からの給付はほとんど不可能です。
And so for this to be paid by the household, by the family, is close to impossible.
まあこれは大学の授業料の推移ですけれども、我々が大学に行った頃は、70年代から80年代にかけてですけれども、大体10万円必要ではありませんでした、1年間に。
And so this figure shows the increase in school fees or university fees in Japan. If we look, for example, at the figures for the 70s or 80s, when we may have been at university, it was actually more like 100,000 yen per year.
今国立大学でも今50万円、60万円になっています。これ文科系でも60万円かかります。
And at even national public universities, it is reaching close to 500 or 600,000 yen per year, even for the liberal arts.
これはなぜこれほど上がるかというと、国からの援助がないからです。
And the reason for this increase is because there is no support or subsidies from the national government.
大学の運営費の国からの補助は全体の 8% に過ぎません。
And of the overall costs for operations of a university, actually only 8% is covered by the government.
これほど教育費にお金をつぎ込まない先進国があるでしょうか?
Are there any other developed countries or industrialized countries that put such little investment, little amount of money into their education system?
子どもの中で格差がものすごく広がっています。
There is a very much growing gap or disparity amongst children in Japan also.
親の学歴とから収入によって、子どもの学力が規定されます。
According to the parents' level of education or income, this has a great impact on the situation of the child also.
それを保障する、支える、術が日本にはありません。
And there are no systems in place in Japan to support this situation.
それを我々民間の力でボランティアでやっているのです。
And so this is the gap which we civil organizations are trying to fill in a voluntary capacity.
これ以降は私たち の活動の様子をお示しますけれども、これはどうしましょう。後でもでしょうか。
今でも。
いいですか。はい。これは私たちが今生活保護を受けている子どもたちの学習支援活動をしていますけれども、そこの世帯は 80% が母子家庭です。
And so from now I would like to introduce some information regarding our organization's activities. We can see for here that actually 80% of the families on welfare who are undertaking learning support provided are families from, with single mothers.
親の学歴も中学校卒か高校中退というのがほぼ半分います。
And when we look at the figures regarding the educational level of the parents of the children coming for this learning support, approximately half of them only graduated from junior high school or partway through high school and dropped out.
大学を卒業している母親はほとんどいません。
There are barely any mothers who have graduated from university.
学歴差は極めてクリアです。
So we can see very clearly this gap between the education levels.
生活保護世帯の家族の中には精神障害、身体障害など障害や疾患を持っている家族が極めて多いです。
Also, when we look at the situation of families on welfare, there is a very high rate of families who have members who are either intellectually or physically disabled.
これは私が調べたデータですけれども、首都圏で、家族の中に、1人以上の障害疾患を持った世帯が生活保護世帯は 56% ありました。
56%ですね。And this is data collected from our survey within the Tokyo metropolitan area. And in families who are on welfare, actually 56% of these families had at least one member with a serious disability.
これは学習支援教室の様子ですけれども、学生ボランティアが頑張っています。
And so this is a photograph of our learning support activities. These are student volunteers who are helping.
私たちは埼玉市でやって学習支援教室を運営していますけれども、11教室あります。
And we are operating learning support classrooms in Saitama City. We have 11 of these centers.
中学生と高校生が450人通っています。
And there are 450 junior and senior high school students attending.
250人の学生たちがそれを支えます。
And 250 student volunteers supporting these activities.
子どもたちはすべて無料です。
These services are all provided free for the children.
こんな様子です。
So this is showing the classroom in action.
支援の私たちの支援の、ポイントはですね、どのくらいの支援対象者をまずターゲッティングすること、
So this is about the particular points regarding our support. First of all is the issue of targeting those people who should receive the support.
今必要な子どもたちは貧困率 16% ですから、子どもの数でいうとざっと350万人ですけども、実際に今支援の対象で、支援ができている数は多分20万人に満たないと思います。
And so if we consider that it is said that the rates of poverty for children now in Japan is approximately 16%, this means that there is a population of approximately 3.5 million children who should be eligible for such support. However, the number who are actually receiving this support is probably less than 200,000.
日本の貧困はほとんど放置されています。
The poverty issue in Japan is almost completely neglected.
それはどういうことかというと、日本の貧困の対策は貧困対策法と生活困窮者自立支援法という2つの法律しかありません。
And well, what does this mean? In fact, there are actually only two pieces of legislation which are in place for this. One is, can roughly be translated to the social welfare law, and the other would be the law for supporting, needy families, should we say.
子どもの貧困対策法にはほとんど予算はついていません。
And for the law in regards to supporting children from needy families, there is almost no budget allocated to this.
生活困窮者自立支援法の学習支援事業のみがですね、子どもの貧困対策の実質的な法律といっても過言ではありません。
And the funding which is applied for the learning support measures for children of families under the poverty line or families receiving or in difficulty, this is probably the only budget which is actually directly implemented for this purpose.
日本の子どもの貧困対策というのはまだ頂についたとは言えないと思います。
I believe that it could not be said that the Japanese measures to alleviate poverty of children have reached what they need to be or reached a peak.
欧米と比べて非常に遅れていると思います。
And this is very much behind if we compare to the situation in countries in the West.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Aoto-san. Thank you very much. And Kuribayashi-san, when you're ready.
こんにちは。私は、東京都の豊島区というところで子どもの居場所づくりをしています、子どもの居場所を作ることによって地域で親だけではなく地域が子どもを一緒に育てる、そういう活動をしています、ここは飛ばしますね。今青戸さんが説明してくださいました。
Good afternoon. I am here from、Toshima Ward in Tokyo、where we are running a center where children can gather or provides them for a place to be, a place to gather and come together. The idea behind this is so that the children can be brought up not only by their parents but with the support of the local community as well. I will skip over the first few slides as I believe they have some information the same as Mr. Aoto.、
私はですね、教師でも何でもない地域の子育てをした母親の一人です。
I myself am not a teacher or any professional in that sense, but I am myself a mother who raised her children in the local area.
町の中で、お腹を空かせている子ども、昨日からご飯を食べていない、そんな子どもたちと今まで出会いました。
And I met often locally, or sometimes locally, children who were hungry, children who had not had anything to eat all that day.
高校に行けないかもしれないという子どもの学習のサポートをしました。
And so I started to provide learning support for children who feared that they may not be able to go on to senior high school.
その一人の子どもから聞いたことはですね、勉強もわからないんだけれども、いつもお母さんから、お金を500円をもらって、それで1日の食費を賄っている。
And one of the children said to me, for example, that, well, I'm not so sure about study or learning, but every day I receive 500 yen from my mother, and that's what we use to get by for one day.
一人で好きな時間に好きなお弁当を買って、食べる、こんな暮らしをしていた子でした。
And so he, this child was using this 500 yen to buy the kind of lunchbox or bento that they wanted to eat any time during the day without any sort of system, and that was how they were surviving every day.
地域の子供が、みんなでご飯を食べること、ワイワイ食べることって楽しいねということや、あの家族が、親が今団らんを作ることができないのなら、地域で団らんを作ろう、そんな思いで、地域のみんなで子ども食堂という取り組みを始めました。
And if facing the situation where local children did not have perhaps opportunities to come together, eat meals together, enjoy together, or if, for example, their parents, families were not able to provide this kind of environment, we decided as the local community to provide such a center or a place where children can gather, have their place together, enjoy their meals, and so on. And so this is what led to what we are calling the Kodomo Shokudo or children's cafeterias.
他にも、子どもの遊び場や勉強だけではなく大学生のボランティアと、遊んだり食べたりできる学習支援も始めました。
And we are also not only providing this food support or place to gather support, but also study support and also support for a place for the children to be able to play, and not only themselves, but to play and eat together with university student volunteers.
日本では子育て支援の子育て拠点の居場所づくりは、国が進めてきています。
In Japan, the national government is putting forward a policy or measures for supporting those bringing up children or space for that.
そのような場が地域にあっても、孤立しがちな親はそこに行けません。行きません。
However, even if such a center is available in the local area, the parents who are already feeling a sense of isolation would not themselves actually attend such places.
親が、地域につながらなくても子どもにつながることによって親の支援もできる、こんな、効果が子ども食堂にはあります。
However, even if the parents themselves do not have such connections or are in a situation where that is not possible for them, we have found through our work that by providing the opportunity for the children to connect with the community, this actually brings back these positive effects on the parents and on the households as well.
これは現場の様子です。ご飯を作るサポートは地域の、主婦が担っています。
So this is a photograph of our support activities. The people here who are providing the food, making the food, are local mothers or housewives.
就学前の子供はお母さんと一緒にご飯を食べに来ます。
And children who are not yet of the school age come together with their mothers to the center to eat.
お寺や教会をお借りして、開かれた地域の子ども食堂をやっている、こんな、現場もたくさんあります。
And there are many locations where, for example, we use premises provided by local temples or churches to set up these 子ども食堂 or children's cafeterias.
一軒家を借りて、中学生専門の子ども食堂、こんなスタイルもあります。
There is also one center where actually a whole house is being rented and support or provision of meals for junior high school students in particular is provided.
本来お弁当を作ったり、お料理を教えるのは家庭かもしれませんが、地域が、それを担っています。
And usually it may be the family members who would be making school lunches for children or teaching them how to cook and so on. However, in these cases, the local community is able to step in and provide such help.
子どもの貧困ということ、そういう問題を知った全国の主婦がうちの町にも同じような取り組みを実現したいということで、子ども食堂は4年前私たちは始めたんですが、今は全国に300箇所以上あると言われています。
And after we launched our center 4 years ago, many housewives or women all over Japan saw this and wanted to make their own centers, their own children's cafeterias to support the poverty alleviation of children in their own local community. Now, from our one center, it has now reached more than 300 centers all over Japan.
子ども食堂につながった子どもは、ずっと地域の誰かが ずっと伴走して就労まで伴走できる、このつながり作りの場所です。
And so the children's cafeteria is not only a place to provide food, but it provides these connections, these links to the local community. And these children are accompanied by members of the local community supporting them right through their education and through even from the, to when they're becoming working age.
食材を提供する方もいれば、手伝う人もいる。困っている子どもを連れてくる人もいる。こうして子ども食堂は町づくり、地域の、ソフトインフラと今なっています。
And as well as this, there are people who are supporting by providing food, providing ingredients, coming along and helping in person or bringing along children who they think may be in need of support as well. In this way, it is also contributing to the community building in the local area and this soft infrastructure.
このように地域の意識を変えることによって子どもが変わります。その子どもが成長して、未来を変えると信じて、この取り組みを進めております。
And we believe that bringing about such changes in the mindset and the way of operating in the local community can also change the children, impact the children in a positive way. Then these children, when they themselves grow up as well, I believe that they themselves will be change makers in the society too. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。
And now for Second Harvest's founder, Mr. Charles McGillen. McGillen. Take it away.
Thank you very much. My name is Charles McGillen. I am the founder of Second Harvest Japan. We are the very first incorporated food bank in Japan and the National Food Bank.A little bit about myself to put it in context why I'd be sitting at this table. I first came to Japan in 1984, came back in 1995, lived in an area called Sanya. As you many may know, it's a low-income area where many day laborers work and live. From January 1997 until April 1998, I actually lived with the homeless in a cardboard house along the Sumida River. So I've been involved with poverty for the last 25 years here in Japan.And observing from different aspects. And so what I present here is just one perspective of it. And I don't want you to take away that it is the only last and the final perspective of it. We've been talking about poverty for a long time, Second Harvest Japan, being back in 2004. And we're always struck by the disconnect between the poverty rate that we were reporting at that time,14-15%, and the reality they were here. In 2013, a company that we'd worked for a long time with and had a lot of research facilities within the organization came to me and said, what's the one thing that keeps you up at night? And both of us expecting that to be fundraising. One thing that kept me up at night is, do we have the numbers correct? Are we seeing poverty in Japan correctly? And so they created this report. And I'm going to go through this report fairly quickly, but I invite anybody here who wants to sit down at a more leisurely discussion to go through it piece by piece with me later on to do that, we can. So they went through this report in 2013, and they also followed up in 2014.And the first thing is that they looked at, you know, what is food security in Japan? You have a handout that I gave you that, based on our documentation of who we think lacks food security here in Japan, we looked at the child poverty countermeasures, we looked at these other perceptions and the government data of being 60% poverty rate. So these are some of the things they looked at. Well, the first thing is, you know, is the existing data usable? Is it accurate?And are we reaching the most people that need to be reached? Their first two conclusions were very startling. The first one is they believe the poverty rate of 16% is too high. The second one is, as you can actually imagine, for us to continue to work with single mothers and the elderly and the poor. I won't go over this, you know, very quickly. You know, this is how poverty rate is reported to the OECD.Just very simply, you know, one half of annual income, if you're 50% of that, you are below the poverty line, relative poverty line. So it measures your income, What these researchers did, you already have this in front of you, you can see here that Japan ranks number four. You can see that poverty rate stretched back. You know, as far back as 1994, Japan was as high as 14%. So why is it suddenly people are talking about it as if it's a major issue here right now, when you've only been within 2 or 3 percentage points for the last 20 years or so? One thing is the perception. If you look at country by country perception, this is the OECD, so OECD data right there, is that in Japan, the poor are largely seen as being lazy. And this may attribute to some reasons why people may not come forward asking for assistance. The second one is they looked at the homeless, because in my experience, almost any English language article about poverty will include a picture of the homeless. But the reality is that since 2009, the number of homeless has actually been halved to 7,500. That's all of Japan, not just Tokyo, but all of Japan. So in other words, homelessness and poverty in Japan is not about homelessness. So what they did is they said, well, let's look at not from income, but let's look at based up on the cost of living. And, you know, how much it costs to live here. And so, again, they gathered data from 47 prefectures. We have a very comprehensive Excel spreadsheet here. Again, happy to sit down with any of you to go through it. And roughly said, this is the cost of living here. And no surprise to really anybody that the numbers were not that much different. Okay? But then they started adjusting it. The first thing they adjusted was, you know, how much income were the elderly getting? How many were homeowners? And how much savings did they have? And this is 2013. They put in dollars, but that's the average savings for elderly. So you could have very low income for elderly, but you have a house, you have savings, so you're pretty much taken care of. They did the same thing for the general population. And this is what they came up with. And this is where the really interesting part here. So they said, if you look at the income threshold below, which is always reported to the OECD, 16%, you take away households that are in dual income, you take away large savings, you take away multi-generational households, and then you get, well, actually, it's about 10%. And again, this comes back to saying, but wait a minute, if we have such a high poverty rate, you know, fourth in the world, right behind the United States, but we don't have the same social issues. We don't have rampant unemployment. We don't have mass of people that are homeless. And even the people that are homeless are generally men over age 55, 60% are former day laborers. They're a narrow demographic of people who are actually homeless. Crime is not an issue here, right? Highly literate society. Corruption is not at the low level. An issue here. So all these social problems you would see attended by a high poverty rate don't exist here. Why not? Well, one reason may be, and again, this is one perspective here, may be that actually if we look at everything here, the poverty rate is actually quite lower than we think. The second thing here is that if you look at, even according to our data, there are about 5 million households below the poverty line. But only the number of households that apply on welfare is just over 2 million. So 60% of households who could qualify for welfare are not on welfare. Again, a very complex reason why, some of I've written down in my FAQ here. But again, we have to look at that. So this is just, I won't go through this, but what they went through and said, well, if these people, who are those 10 million people? The majority, as you would not be surprised, are the general population. But the second biggest one are the elderly. We're a gradually graying population with over 25% are above 65. So even among these households here. So again, looking up from the bottom up, you get a different picture here. Speaking about our organization here, we have been doing food banking here, as I said, since 2002. We incorporated. And within Tokyo itself, there are about maybe 40 to 50 locations you can pick up food, emergency food, maybe a hot meal or something. In New York City, there are 1,100. Chicago has 600. San Francisco has 250. Even nearby Hong Kong has 520. Why do we have so few here? Second of all, we continually try to work with other partners to say we have plenty of food available. We're willing to give it out. In fact, we have a very low threshold for providing assistance to people. If you show up at my office and warehouse to get food, we'll provide it to you, no questions asked. Now, we will ask that second time you get a letter of introduction from one of the 88 government agencies that we work with. In spite of that, every week we only get about 50 to maybe top 60 households coming picking up food from us. So again, is there a real need out there? Or are there other things and factors in place? The last one to think consider is that a lot of the common partners that you would find, as you mentioned, my country, United States, where I was born, come from, either don't exist here or don't see that this issue is a major problem. Okay. We work with Adachiku. We worked with them for the last year in different capacities of trying to build a food safety net there to provide more food up there. Why Adachiku? Because Adachiku, as was pointed out, one third of the kids that go to school there are on some type of public assistance. Okay? And you can see the direct reflection that they have the lowest test scores among the 23 wards. All right? So we've been working with them, and last year they sent out flyers to 5,000 households, and out of that 800 came down to us between January, February, and March to pick up food from us. This is great. We're really excited about this. But there was no follow-up after that. There was no next step. How are we going to reach all these people? If there really is a genuine need in your area there, we're more than happy to provide the food. Now, just to put this last piece in context here, sometimes people think we don't have enough food. This is not food waste. This is all of the available food in 1 year in Japan that gets destroyed. It's safe. I'm not talking about leftover food from your banquet or the 7-Eleven. I'm not talking about that food. I'm talking about food that either never makes it to the market or it's in the market and it's convenient. Right? That's 3 million. That's about 3 million tons of that. Okay? This is what we did last year. One bean. Not for the lack that we don't want it to do it, right? Not for the lack of great staff, not for lack of great partners, but we don't have those other partners in the field to provide assistance. So, okay, come back to that. If there really is a genuine need and we have a way to provide one basic need, a human need to eat, right? Why aren't more people coming to me and asking for my assistance? Where are they? Okay. But it's a question. I don't offer like I have an answer to that, but just a different perspective. What we want, what we hope, and again, we always work for partners, is three things here. One, have the government come out and do a comprehensive study on poverty within the 23 wards. Now, Adachiku has done that, right? But do a comprehensive study on what is poverty, what is the situation here? And within that, include a key question of who lacks food security? Who lacks the ability to get three meals a day? All right. And the third one is to talk about, again, how can we expand this conversation to include more partners involved to get the food to people who need it. So that's kind of where we're coming from on this. We want to get the correct data so we can get the correct answers. We want to get the correct data so that we can provide the assistance in a way that makes sense for everybody involved. Kudasan, she works, she is a part of our food safety net network that we created in 2015 to help talk about this issue. Right? We know we got people in need, we have plenty of resources. How come we can't reach those kids? How can we can't reach those families? How can we can't reach those people in need there? You know, what is it? And so, our last goal by 2020 Olympics, we announced this 3 years ago, we followed up with our annual symposium recently, was to create a food safety net that would match our society here, that will allow 100,000 people throughout the week get access to the food they need. We have something similar to that today. We have a healthcare safety net. Right? It's fantastic. In the 1960s, they passed the laws that all children here will be covered by healthcare up to age 16. It's something we take for granted here, but if you're not from here, you can realize what the benefit of that is. And it's in the schools where children undergo health checks. as a local hospital in case you get in an accident, as at the prenatal care. All these ways, this health care safety net is embedded into our society, and we live better, and we feel much more safe. Our philosophy, our idea, let's do the same thing for food. Let's create that food safety net so that anybody in need today within Tokyo has the ability to get food. That no child should have to go to school on an empty stomach. That no child should have to go to sleep on an empty stomach. We have the resources. We have the resources to make this thing happen. So that's where we come from. I thank you for my time.
Thank you very much. Right, now the floor is open for Q&A. Anyone who might be interested, step forward to the microphone, please. State your name, organization, question, and if it's a specific question for one of our speakers or a general question for the panel. Thank you very much.
今日ご苦労様です。東協会の会員で、田中隆作と申します。栗林さんと青田さんにお伺いいたします。ですね、子どもの貧困対策というのは、もう政府の責任、国家の責任であるにもかかわらずですね、安倍晋三さんという人は、その子ども食堂をやってくれるおじさん、おばさんがいるからいいんだ、勉強を教えてくれるお兄さん、お姉さんがいるからいいんだ。皆さんも頑張ってくださいなんていうすごい無責任なことを言ってますが、その見解についてはどう思われますか？
I am a journalist. My name is Ryusaku Tanaka. I am a member of the FCCJ. I have a question for Mr. Aoto and Ms. Kuribayashi. Despite the fact that social welfare or support for people living in poverty should be the responsibility of the government, we have the situation now in Japan where the Prime Minister Abe Shinzo is making very irresponsible statements such as, well, there are these children's cafeterias provided by volunteers, which is all fine, so they can do it. There are these student volunteers who are doing everything, so we can leave it up to them. They'll look after everything. These very irresponsible statements. I would like to ask your opinion on these.
まあ、私たち今まで地域の中で活動しています。地域の中に子どもの貧困という問題を伝えてもですね、見えないんですね。だからみんなうちの町にはない、こんなふうな答えが多かったです。しかし国がこの問題はあるんです、とりあえず取り組まなくてはいけないということを、公表したというかですね、法律を作ったことはある意味私は大きい一歩だなと思っています。そういうことによってまず住民がそういう問題があるんだこの国にも、そういう意味では大変ありがたいです、こういうふうに言ってもらうのは。しかしやはり、
First of all, we of course were working very much in the local community on a very local level until now. However, we faced a situation where when we would tell about the situation of children living in poverty, often people would think that it was not visible or they themselves had not come across it, so were not aware of this. They might think, well, that's not happening in our town, in our community. However, the fact that, well, the country, the national government has recognized this by even mentioning that something needs to be done and did put in place a law in regards to this, did at least make this problem visible and make the people aware that, well, something needs to be done about this, that it is in fact a problem. However,
しかし、やっぱり国がそこにもうちょっとアプローチをしないことは確かに不十分だと思うんですけれども、まずは市民がですね、こういう問題があるということを知って、そのためにこういう取り組みが必要なんじゃないか。子ども食堂や学習支援をきっかけに、やっぱり国民がですね、将来の子どもたちのことをみんなで考えて、まあ、そういう意味で、ちゃんと行政に伝えていく、こういうことが必要なんじゃないか。そうやって、まあ市民と行政が共同という形で取り組みが進んでいかなくてはいけない問題だと思いますけれども、まずはその一歩として、こういう問題があるんですと安倍さんが言ってくれたことはですね、私たちがいくら言っても伝わらない人がたくさんいる、町には見えないから、見えない問題を見えることに見えるように、してくださったことはまず大きな一歩だなと思っています。
Of course, however, even despite this, I believe that the government should be approaching this issue more, and its current measures in regards to poverty alleviation are insufficient. However, the fact that, well, first of all, by these citizens could actually learn that this problem exists and start to consider the measures which are necessary for this, such as being involved in provision of children's cafeterias or learning support, so on, makes people, or it's given people an opportunity to think about children's future in this way. So I call on the government really to, well, it's necessary for people to be calling on the government to actually be taking more steps and more measures regards to this, because of course this is a problem which needs cooperation between both citizens and the government in order to resolve this issue as well. Therefore, the fact that Mr. Abe actually raised this or mentioned this as a problem did help a lot of people actually realize that it is an issue existing in Japan. Even if we were mentioning this ourselves, there were a lot of people who our voices were not reaching, who were not hearing this. So the fact that he's at least raised it is a first step.
Abe-san は一言で言うと、安倍さんは子どもの貧困とか貧困問題には関心ないと思います。
To put it very simply, I do not believe that Mr. Abe has any interest in issues of children's poverty or poverty overall.
それはまあ、これは保守党の、皆さん共通したものだと思いますけれども、子どもの貧困問題や貧困問題は票にはならないからです。
And I think this is an issue which is common to all conservative parties, but issues such as poverty and children's poverty in particular, these do not lead to votes.
やはり今の、日本の小選挙区制の下では、やはり当面の選挙に勝ち抜くということは、極めて現実的でリアリティを持った本当に直面した課題をやっていくということが中心になっていくと思います。
And within the current electoral system in Japan, the reality is that rather than long-term issues, it is very much based, or votes are based on, or the direct issues which are being felt in an immediate way.
子どもの貧困問題というのは何がなぜ大切かというと、それを我々が対応することは、解決することは、日本社会の30年後、40年後が決定するからです。
But the issue of poverty of children, well, the reason it is so important and the reason it is so necessary to respond to this and resolve this is actually because of 30 or 40 years from now.
現実の世界だけしか見えない政治家たちには、子どもが40年後、50年後にどういう人生を歩むかというのは見えるとは到底思えません。
Therefore, those politicians who are very much living in the world of the immediate reality, I doubt whether they are actually, or whether they even have the capacity to consider the lives of children 45, 55 years from now in the future.
2020年の東京オリンピックは予想できても、2060年の日本の人口が8000万人になってしまうかもしれないと、そういう世界の想像力がやっぱり欠けてると思います。
So while they may be able to imagine the Tokyo Olympics in 2020, whether they can imagine the fact that the Japanese population will by 2060 be dropping to 80 million, I don't think this is the case.
私たちはそこを問題にしているのです。
And this is the issue to which we are paying attention.
Thank you very much. Next question. Yes, sorry, in the back. Take you afterwards, sir. In the back.
日本語で失礼いたします。私は三輪よし子と申しまして、フリーのジャーナリストです。で、2011年以後、貧困問題、特に生活保護の問題にフォーカスして記事を書いてまいりました。で、私が今一番聞きたかったことは、田中隆作さんが今聞いてくださいましたが、ので私は次に聞きたいことをお三方に聞かせていただければと思います。通訳どうぞ。
I am a freelance journalist. I have been following this issue closely since around 2011. Actually, the question which I most wanted to ask was actually asked now by Mr. Tanaka. So I would like to ask a different question, and this is for all three speakers.
まずですね、私はこの子どもの貧困問題はですね、国難レベルの話だと理解しています。国難なんですから、もう民間に好意や善意があるかないかと無関係に国家予算を 動かさないといけないと思っています。で今日本には生活保護という制度がありますから、これを、保護費個々の世帯に渡る、ベネフィット、の金額や、受けられる人数、必要とする人が1000万人はいるだろうと言われているのに220万人以下しかいません。そういったことも含めた拡充と、それから使いやすく分かりやすくすることが大事だと思います。まずこの点に関してのご意見をお三方に聞かせていただけないでしょうか。
And I believe that the issue of poverty for children in Japan is not just on an individual level, but it is indeed a national problem. Therefore, even though there may be citizens with goodwill who are undertaking such, well, citizens in initiatives, activities, and so on, I believe that national budget should be allocated in order to deal with this issue. Considering that we do have the social welfare system in Japan, however, the number of people who are actually receiving benefits who may be available for them, 1000万のうち So only around 2.2 million people of the probably around 10 million who would actually be eligible for this are actually receiving these benefits, I think is an issue. Therefore, how would it be possible to make it easier or more accessible for people who do need this kind of support, and what kind of measures should be in place in regards to the social welfare system? If we can ask this of all three speakers.
Aoto-san, if you would like to go first, please.
Aoto-san, please. Okay. できますでしょうか。
生活保護のこの利用者が少ないという問題は、一つはもうこれは非常にはっきりしています。予算の総額が決まっています。予算の総額が。ですからこれは生活保護費というのは国の予算と、それから地方自治体の予算と両方合わさってそれで成立しています。ですからその予算額が決まっている以上、これはですね、地方自治体にとっても国にとっても利用者を増やすわけにはいかないのです。ですからそれはですね、利用者が増えてもこれは切ります。で必要なくなったら切ります。これをどんどんやります。これはもうこれはこういう制度だからです。まずそれが一つ。それからですね。
じゃあそこまで。So first of all, I believe that there is a systematic issue which is very clear as to the reason that the number is so low. And this is in related to the fact that the total amount for the social welfare budget is already set. This is a combination on the national and local level, but as long as this actual total is set, then, well, the number of beneficiaries, for example, cannot be increased if there is more of a need and so on as well. Therefore, those people, if they, for example, becomeno longer targets, they're immediately cut off from the social welfare system and so on. So there is this very systematical aspect in place.
これはですから、したがって使いやすいかど、使えるような制度なのかということは予算によって決まります。まあ、これは先ほど申し上げた回答でお分かりだと思います。極めてこれは生活保護はもらいづらいです。要するに利用しづらいです。ですから欧米の例えばヨーロッパ社会で福祉手当というものと日本の生活保護費は全く違います。ですからそれはこれだけ、要するに今日本の貧困率の大体 10% です。10分の1の人々しか生活保護、要するに最後のセーフティーネットが利用できていません。だから最後のセーフティーネット制度というのは日本の本当に必要な人たちの大体 10% しか使えてないのです。
And if we consider the question of whether this system is accessible enough or easy enough to use, well, this is itself also affected or decided by these budget limitations as well. Therefore, I believe that it can be said it's extremely difficult to access for those who find it or for whom it's necessary. If we compare this, for example, to the system in Europe, the system of social welfare in Japan and the social benefits available in European countries is actually a completely different system in that regards. So when we consider the poverty rate in Japan and the number of people who are actually able to have access to this, it's actually the situation that a very low, only around 10% of the people for whom it's actually necessary are able to reach this final safety net. And I think the reasons for this is perhaps clear by the explanation I provided.
もう一つだけ付け加えさせていただくと、そういうふうに初めから非常に使いづらい制度である。ですから生活保護を受けるということは日本社会ではスティグマになります。
And one further point to add, since from the beginning this system is made to be very difficult to use or access, actually it means that in the Japanese society, being on social welfare also comes with a great stigma.
僕の知っている子どもたち、貧しいうちの子どもですけども、要するに祖母が子どもを孫娘を育てているという家庭があります。
In one family I know in which they are facing the situation of child poverty. This is a situation where the grandmother is looking after the grandchild.
本当は生活保護を受けなければ生活できないのですけれども、その祖母はですね、親戚に知られると、生活保護を受けるということを知られると、私は生きていけないというふうに言います。
However, there is the situation where this family without social welfare, in fact, would be very difficult for them to live. However, the situation with other family members as well.
ということをですね、しているということを親戚の皆さんに知られると、私は生きていけないと。
Excuse me. So this grandmother is in the situation where if her relatives were to find out that actually she was receiving social welfare benefits, she would not be able to survive for a different reason as well. So very much stuck between these difficult situations.
地方に行けば行くほどそういう状況はたくさんあります。ですから生活保護率は非常に低い。
And this situation becomes much more exacerbated in more rural areas as well. It becomes much more serious. Therefore, the actual rates of people on social welfare is much lower in some of these areas accordingly.
Thank you. Would you like to say something? Yes, please.
はい、します。私は、生活保護を利用しているお母さんも、または生活保護の基準以下で暮らしている、頑張ってダブルワーク、トリプルワークをして頑張っているお母さんも、そういう方から、よくいろんな話を聞いています。
I often hear many or much information or stories from mothers, for example, those who are receiving social welfare benefits or mothers who are living under the standard for which they would be eligible for them, but rather than receiving social welfare, they are having double or even triple jobs to get by.
仕事に一生懸命で子どもに向き合えず不登校になってしまう子ども、いろんな困難を抱えている子どもがたくさんいます。
And there are many children from such families, for example, where the parents have to work for such long hours or so hard that they do not have sufficient time to spend to care for their children. Therefore, the children, for example, stop going to school and so on.
そういう方に生活保護を進める場合もあれば、一緒に窓口に行って申請する場合もあります。
And in such cases, there are situations where, for example, I recommend them to consider starting to receive social welfare benefits, or sometimes I even go together with them to the office in order to sign up and go through the application procedures together.
しかしほとんどのお母さんは、そういう生活保護だけは、利用したくない、そんな声も多いです。
However, actually the majority of mothers very much resist and say, well, social welfare, that would be the last straw. I do not want to have to actually go on to that.
それはやはり生活保護という制度に対して、すごくこうプラスのというかですね、のイメージがなかったり、実際私たち利用していない私たちも本当にその制度のことを分かってないんじゃないか、そんなふうに思いました。
And I thought that one part of the reason for this is the fact that, well, there is no positive image in relation to receiving social welfare benefits in Japan. And the second could be that those of us who do not have to receive such benefits actually do not have an image or an understanding of what the system actually is.
しかし地域の一主婦が、そんなことを思ったとしても何にも変えることはできません。
However, of course, if just one local mother or just one member of the local community thinks this, well, it's not possible to change the system.
そこで、私たちは、生活保護を利用して今納税者になっている人に実名と、顔写真を出して生活保護という制度を語ってもらう、こんな、手弁当の冊子を作りました。
And as one measure to deal with this, we actually made a small publication or a brochure from our own resources, our own funds, which has the stories of people who were receiving social welfare and have now become taxpayers. So they're actually using their real names and faces in this brochure to tell their stories.
私は、私たちがいくら言っても制度やですね、そういう大きなことは変えることはできないけれども、できることを、何かを批判するのではなく、できることを住民がやっていくことによって、仲間を増やしていき、声を上げていく、いけるんじゃないか、そんな思いを持っていますが、実際に、そういう取り組みがですね、継続してずっと奮起できるのはやはり常に現場のお母さんたちの声を聞いてるからなんじゃないかなと思ってます。
Therefore, of course, there may be limitations to what we on our level with our capacity can do to actually change the system itself, and it's not possible for us to immediately make changes in the system. However, there are things which we can do to make a change. Therefore, rather than just raising criticisms, we are looking as citizens, as residents, what we can actually do to raise this and to bring up these issues and information. Therefore, also bringing more people into the circle of partners to work with us, raise this voice more. And the reason we are able to continue such initiatives is because we are hearing on an everyday basis these voices.Of the mothers in the local community.
Thank you. McGillison, sir, would you like to?
Yeah, I mean, I think that for us, there's a couple of things. We always look for new partners, whether it be the government or non-government organizations, to work together to get the information to people. And our long-term objective is to see that we truly are partners of the government.To work with them to provide services to people that are in need. And it's a long-term vision, but we believe that we can get there. We have evidence from the corporate side, food companies. We started out in 2002 with just two companies. Now we have 1,100 companies. And if you know a Japanese food company, they're most conservative in the world. Not politically conservative, I'm saying, but just in terms of how they handle the food, who they engage with. And so it took a while to get there, but we were able to accomplish that. And we believe the long-term objective could be that also with the government.To see them as a partner and as an adversary, but also see them to how to get let people know about our services. And as you see sometimes in other countries where the NGO itself helps to get people on welfare they need it or get them on food stamps if they need it. So the last one I would say is to, I would echo what they've also said, and we heard the same stories, that there's a deep stigma about families on welfare, and even times the children don't even know that they are on welfare, that maybe we think about reframing that discussion, reframing about what that means to be on welfare. And as you saw one of our slides that showed that people who are soon to be on welfare or poor are lazy to think, who are these people and what does it mean to us as a collective society? So those are the things that, you know, for us looking forward is in a positive way, looking for partners, retelling the story in a different way, and looking for the long-term solution.
Thank you. There was a question down from the back, please. Thank you.
I'm Khalil, I'm an honorary member. Thank you very much for coming and explaining, you know, this important issue. You did a lot of work.
Who do you, sorry, excuse me, pardon me, sorry, your organization? Your organization, sir?
I am Ambassador of Bahrain.
Thank you, sorry.
Okay, you did a lot of work to treat this situation. And there is a say which says,An ounce of prevention better than tons of treatment. But my question is, do you think you have an important role to play to help to prevent this issue, to make the government look at it more, to consider it one of its priorities? As you mentioned before, that the government made health care is for all the children who are below 16 years of age free. Can you work on this issue and make food is for all the children before 16 years, you know, something like that? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador.
Yes, I think it is possible. And I think it takes a lot of different things that we're very good at, we've been able to do. One is to partner with a wide variety of people, to be persistent but respectful when we're engaging the government, to not treat them as an adversary but as a potential partner with a shared interest in trying to create something better. The second one of that is to remember, and this is my, I'm going to speak for myself personally, Charles McGilton, that democracy begins with the individual, not the government. That the solutions begin with the individual, not the government. That to us collectively coming together as a community, we can create something greater. That the government does play a role, but they're not the only solution. And until, you know, they can come forward and feel comfortable doing what they need to do, there is a lot of things together collectively that we can do together. We can bring a lot of different ideas from outside Japan and apply them to the context of here in Japan. That's what we're very good at, you know, to engage a lot of different people. And when I say doing positively, have humor. Have a sense of humor about it. It's a deadly issue, but to think long term, just to hang in there, you know, to get frustrated, to get disappointed every single day won't get you across that finish line. But again, to remember that these are people that are partners that have a common interest, to see that all kids are fed.
Thank you.
おっしゃるとおり、パートナーシップはとても大事です。で、私たちの団体も、さいたま市と共同でこの事業を行っています。
As was mentioned, partnership is indeed very important. And in fact, our organization is also working in cooperation with the city of Saitama in order to implement our activities.
さいたま市は120万人の人口を持っています。
The city of Saitama has a population of 1.2 million.
120万人を行政だけで、子どもの貧困対策できるわけがありません。
And it would not be possible for just the city alone to be able to deal with or fully respond to the situation of poverty, child poverty in a city of such a size.
しかし、生活困窮者自立支援法という法律があります。
However, there is a law in place which is, well, the law in regards to assistance for people in need.Or the National Assistance Act, I believe, is the abbreviated English term.
法律は法律があるから、法律は使おうと思えば、国から予算をもらうとき、これは自治体がもらいます。
And since this legislation has been put in place, there is also a budget made available for this. If an application is made, then a local municipality is eligible for receiving some budget through this Assistance Act.
民間の NPO が直接もらえることはできないのです。
It is not possible for an NPO or a citizens organization to receive funding from or through this act.
私たちが企画を出しても、計画を、プランを作っても、行動しても、お金が来るためには、やっぱりどうしてもこれは行政と、パートナーシップを作る、作らざるを得ないです。
Therefore, even if our organization were to put in place plans, proposals, and even actions, it would not actually be possible to access any funds as a non-profit organization or a civil organization. Therefore, it is actually necessary to have this kind of institutional partnership with the local government.
まあ、日本社会では全てそう、大体そういうことが言えると思います。
And I believe that this is the case actually for most elements within Japanese society.
だけどもそれでも、行政と手を、パートナーシップをやらないで、民間独自でやっている方々もたくさんいます。
However, there are of course many people and organizations who are working independently as a citizens organization without forming a partnership with government.
それは自由だからです。
And this is because it is of course free to make that choice.
ただ日本は給付文化がありません。
However, in Japan, there is not a culture of private donations or philanthropy.
非常にだから苦戦をしています。
Therefore, it is very difficult for such organizations.
やっぱりですからこれからの課題はやはり 行政からお金をもらって行政とやっぱりしっかり手を結びながら地域社会に責任を持ってコミュニティを作っていく、コミュニティを再建していくというこういう努力を我々は今目指しています。
Therefore what we are now facing as our challenge or what we are aiming for as well is coming from the situation where it's only possible to implement such activities or create such community building while relying on funds which come through partnership from government but to look for an alternative community building or rebuilding in this way.
2つ目に僕たちがやっていることはやはり自分たちでお金を集めて自由に地域社会との中にコミュニティを作るというですね、2つ目のやり方。
And so the second thing we are doing as well is looking for what donations we can collect ourselves and in this way so that it can be freely used together with the local community for community building in the area.
セカンドハーベストからも我々はたくさん食料をいただいています。
And in fact, we also receive much food provided from Second Harvest.
毎日子どもたちがそのセカンドハーベストからいただいたものを食べています。
And so the children attending our activities are actually every day eating food which is provided through Second Harvest.
そういうパートナーシップも広がることが僕たちの夢でもあります。
And so expansion of these forms of partnership is also the dream for which we are working now.
それで点と点を結びながら大きな面になっていけばいいなというふうに考えています。
And so we hope that by connecting these dots, which are perhaps independent now, we can create something much larger together.
Thank you very much. Kuribayashi-san?
はい。私は町の中でこんな声を聞きます。昔はみんな貧しかったんだ、だけど頑張った、なんで頑張らないんだ、こんなふうな声を聞くんですね。昔はみんな貧しかったんです。みんなが貧しくって、しかし地域のつながりがありました。今はそのつながりがない中、大変な人は大変って言えない、つながりがない、こんな状況があるんじゃないかと思います。
One thing I often hear in the local community is people saying, well, once ago, you know, it used to be that everybody was poor, but we all worked hard. We were able to get over this ourselves. Why are people not able to do that now? Often people have such issues. However, while it may have been the case that people were in a difficult situation or indeed poor,There were different community connections or bonds in place within the community at that time. However, now people are facing the situation where if they do not have these kinds of connections within the local community, if they are in trouble, they are not able to speak out and call for help.
貧困と孤立、貧困と孤立と虐待は、すごく深く関係があると言われています。
It is said that there is a very deep relationship between poverty, isolation, and abuse.
日本では子どもの虐待も増えているんですけれども、中でも0歳から3歳の虐待が多いです。
It is thought that the child abuse rates in Japan are also increasing, and within this, this is particularly for children of the age of 0 to 3 years old.
このような子どもたちは地域にしかいないわけです。
However, these children, of course, their only environment is the local community.
だとしたら、地域で、いろんなつながりを作っていくことによって、頑張る根っこ、子どもの、生きていく土壌を作っていくことが、とても効率が高いんじゃないかなと私は思います。
Therefore, I believe that the effective way to deal with this and to will prevent further of this problem as well is to look at how to create connections within the local community to support. And this can indeed create foundations for the children for the future.
そういうつながりの中で当たり前に、遊んで、安心して眠ってお腹いっぱいご飯を食べる、この、繰り返しがですね、生きてくその子の根っこを作るんだと思います。
And by creating connections within the community and providing an environment in which the children can play in a free way that they can take for granted, can sleep feeling safe, and can eat until their stomachs are full. This is the way to create the roots for these children for their future.
困っている子どもをど真ん中に地域の多くの人がつながってみんなで声を上げていけば、食の問題も少し解決するんじゃないか。そして、学校給食 当たり前にお金がある子もない子もみんなが安心して無料で義務教育として食べられる、そんな社会がそのずっと先にあるんだとしたら、今できることを私はやるしかないかなと思ってます。
Therefore, if we consider, well, a child who is facing such problems at the center of the community and everyone within the community linking together to connect and raise this issue together as well without relying on the person suffering the problem. Through doing this, I think that we can also make an impact or a positive impact in the problem of food as well. If we are looking towards the future of eventually being able to have school lunches provided for all children, whether they actually have the finances for that themselves or not, and to be able to make this available for free as part of their compulsory education, then I think if this is the long-term goal, there are many things which we can be doing now, and that is what our work is.
子ども食堂が拠点となり、全国に、そういう声がつながる、そのために、この前9月から、広がれ子ども食堂の輪全国ツアーというキャラバンを始めました。
And with our children's cafeteria that we set up as the center, we are now working to connect such voices from all over Japan as well to raise this as an issue and work together. Since September, we have started an activity where actually a caravan to travel around to different parts of Japan and connect these different children's cafeterias to raise a voice collectively as well.
これは、啓発することによって多くの人が、子ども食堂、食を切り口に貧困問題を、掘り下げて考える、こういう仲間を増やすために、もしかして成果があるかもしれない、ないかもしれないけれども、できることとして楽しくこのキャラバンをスタートしました。
And through such awareness raising and advocacy activities, we are using the issue of food as an entry point. And from this, hoping that people can go on to look at the deeper issues of poverty as well. We, of course, hope that this will lead to some results. We are not sure, of course, what will actually happen or result from our work. However, we are doing what we can to implement this now and to do it while having fun as well.
Thank you very much. I think we have time for one more question, very briefly. If anyone is. Sorry. Yes, please. Peter? And the answers, we have about 10 minutes left, so the answers briefly, please.
My name is Lang, and I work for Asia Times, which is based in Hong Kong. I'm a little confused because for Mr. McNaughton, we're getting one sort of set of data that seems to be saying that the 16% poverty rate is wrong. It's actually not as bad as that. It's only 10%. But then we're also hearing that there's actually a lot of children who are suffering and that this situation is going to get worse. So which way is this going? Is it more that the social stigma that's been brought up is the main issue, that you just can't capture the data because people are not registering for welfare? Or it's kind of difficult for a journalist, if you're going to write a headline about this, what is the headline? It's getting worse, it's the same, it's getting better. You know, where is it?
Thank you. Well, Mickelton-san?
Well, as I said at the very beginning, you know, I'm speaking from one perspective and a group that did some study on it. Happy to sit down with you a little bit at length to explain where they got the data from. I think the biggest difference is how you're measuring it. The OECD measures income. So what they measured, the people I did, was measured how much money are people using to get by and are they in multiple different households. So maybe my income is low. For example, I'm a single parent, but I'm living with my parents and my grandparents. So, well, my income is low, and I'm below 16%. I'm part of that 16% of poverty rate. I'm getting by. I'm covered. My basic needs are being met. So that's where you need to kind of keep in, you know, kind of look at it. The second side, as I mentioned, is that the numbers since 1994 haven't really changed that much, what the government's reporting. So again, we need to take a deeper dive into what do those numbers actually mean? Why aren't people actually accessing the services that are available? And then lastly, along that same kind of, you know, thought process is the government does have the data of who is on welfare, right? But they obviously, for privacy reasons, they don't release that information. right? So instead of just saying, well, we know that the income level is here, right? Maybe below that is poverty line, the more granular you release the data would be helpful for people like us in the field to help to reach those people.
Thank you. Aoto-san.
この議論は一つ大きな問題は日本政府 の, 日本全体の全国 の, 貧困率の調査というのはあります。これは政府がやっている、政府がやっている。だけど
One of the problems related to this debate is that, well, there is a national Japanese government survey of the overall poverty rates.
このデータの取り方は、要するに厚生労働省のデータの取り方、それから内閣府のデータの取り方、少しずつ違います。
And one of the issues, however, is this data is actually being accumulated in a slightly different way by the Ministry of Health and the Cabinet.
国民の消費生活に それに視点を置く見方から雇用に視点を置く見方、そして差が出ます。
And there are differences, for example, in how the public's consumer activities or employment rates are evaluated as part of these figures.
この2つの視点とも、これは十数年間、要するに2000年に入って以降も国民生活は確実に悪化しています。それからもう一つ、賃金も低下しています。
And there are two aspects in regards to this. First of all, if we look at the figures since, well, just after 2000 or for 10 plus years, the actual situation of people's lives has very much deteriorated in this time. And also the issue of income or salary has also really stayed at a very similar rate throughout this whole time.
生活保護世帯も増えています。
There is also an increase in the number of households on welfare.
日本の貧困化が進行している進行しているというエビデンスは非常にたくさんあります。
There is a great amount of evidence which indicates that the rates of poverty are progressing or worsening in Japan.
課題は日本は47都道府県ありますけれども、その地方自治体できちっとしたデータのチェックがありません。
However, one of the great issues is that there is not actually a sufficient check of the data within the local municipalities within the 47 prefectures of Japan.
そこが一つ大きな課題です。
So that's one great challenge.
しかし、日本の貧困化が進行しているという雇用、それから消費生活、それから賃金、これはみんな日本の、国民生活は、劣化しています。
However, if we look at the situation of the poverty rates, the consumption or consumer activities, and also income, we can see a clear deterioration in the situation in Japan.
Thank you very much. Could we ask John? No, it's okay. It's okay. Well, thank you very much. In that case, we are just about ready for time. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
And, そしてこちらスピーカーとしてお越しいただいている方には
1年間の
名誉会員証というものをお渡ししていますので。